Friends, welcome you all in this course on commodity marketing and futures trading. In this course, we will try to understand what is commodity marketing and what is futures trading. But before that, we will try to understand what is commodity per se. So, a commodity is a product that has a commercial value, which can be produced, which can be sold, bought and consumed. So, a commodity is an article or product that is used for trade or commerce, that is movable, that has economic value, which can be bought and sold and is produced or used as a subject in a barter or sale. So, how the commodity is being traded? So, there are different ways of trading commodities. First is physical trade, which is very popular, which is very common, then forward transactions and futures trade. So, we try to understand all these. First, we will try to learn what is physical markets. Physical markets, in other words, we call it cash and carry market or spot market. Cash and carry market because one has to take the cash in the market and negotiate with the seller of the commodity and take the commodity at the and give the cash at the spots. That is why it is called cash and carry market. So, in this market, sellers agree to deliver the commodity and buyers agrees to make the payment of on the spot. So, delivery of commodity happens at on the spot as well as payment of transaction happens on the spot. That is how it is called spot market. Purchases are settled in cash at whatever the prices they have agreed upon mutually. So, trades are executed through party to party contract or one to one contract between buyer and seller. And for example, if you happen to be in a mandi or what we call it agriculture produce market, what you see there, producer or a farmer or a village aggregator with their produce, they brought in maybe through tractor trolleys or through truckload or through cartload, they come in the market, the buyers may be retailers, exporters, processors or even consumers come in the market as a buyer. They negotiate maybe in the presence of a commission agent or aditya we call it, and they fix on prices, they decide on prices to be transacted. So, this is the mandi is we can call it as a physical market. The advantages of the physical markets are buyer can select and buy the specific commodity required in the market. The quality he can decide on. The quantity he can decide on by visual inspection in the market. There are certain limitations of physical markets which we will try to understand what are those. First, the transactions in this market are subject to the price risk. You know, the agriculture commodities particularly, they are seasonal in nature. Their production is in a particular season and the produce come to the market mainly after harvest. So, there is bulk of the produce after harvest and with the large produce in the markets, the prices has to go down because of lack of demand to that extent and because of higher supplies in the market. So, there is a demand supply imbalance that creates market fluctuations, and with that, since there are agro industries, they need commodity round the year, but with this seasonality in nature of agri commodities, they need to buy the commodity at just after harvest. So, at one point of time, they need to buy the commodity and store that commodity for whole years of their requirement for running the industry. And in that way, they have to incur the storage charges and even bear the whatever storage losses are there. So, farmers need credit after harvest and does not have storage capacity because they have invested lot of money in producing that commodity, and for that they might have taken credit from banks or cooperatives or even money lenders. So to repay that loan, they need immediate money from the harvest, whatever they had. So they don't have any storage capacity. That is how immediate sell, or what we can call it as a distress sell. Another limitation is there is very high cost of intermediation in these physical markets, because once the produce starts for marketing from producer till it reaches and to the end consumer, there are n number of intermediaries involved in it, and just changing the hands, commodity just changing the hands, and every intermediary is making his profits and incurring marketing costs. So there is the cost, there is a significant cost in the intermediation. Then whenever farmers go for sale of his produce to the mandis or agriculture produce markets, he doesn't know about what are the prices in the market. So he is ignorant about the prices in that market where he is going to sell, or the nearby markets where he can fetch better price. Then another limitation is farmers are unable to predict the market accurately, but way market will behave, and there is lack of effective mechanism to eliminate price risk. So since we have learned that there is a lot of variations, there are a lot of fluctuations in the commodity prices, there is no way how the farmers can be saved from the price risk. Now we will try to understand the value chain of a commodity or any agriculture commodity. Value chain comprises of all activities and all services undertaken along a commodity chain. That is, from the produce travels from primary producer to it reaches final consumer, and it includes different activities to be performed along the value chain and different services to be performed along the value chain. Then the players includes producers. If we talk about agriculture commodities, farmers are the producers. Another players are assemblers, traders, processors, distributors, retailers, and of course final consumers. So analysis of value chain helps players at various stages of the chain to increase their profitability. So for that one must know how the value chain works and what are the activities of the value chain. Now we will try to understand the regulation of agriculture markets and physical market setup for agriculture commodities in our country. Since agriculture and agriculture marketing by constitution is a state subject, so agriculture marketing also is being regulated by state agencies. State government at the nodal level regulates agriculture marketing through Directorate of Agriculture Marketing, or in some states there are agriculture marketing boards. Before independence, there was no regulation of agriculture markets. So the traders or intermediaries, they used to exploit farmers. They deduct n number of charges in terms of karda, dalta, muddat, dharmada, and to save farmers from these unwanted deductions from the farmers, government came up with a regulation, and Agriculture Produce Market Regulation Act came into being, and farmers has to market in Agriculture Produce Market Committee set up market mandi yards. So markets, agriculture produce market committees were set up to regulate the markets, and the committees may be nominated in some states or may be elected in some of the states. Those committees manage the agriculture markets in all the states. But with the market liberalization, the different problems have arisen out in agriculture marketing system. So there was a need for model act in marketing reforms. So the market reforms came into being. Now the different participants in physical markets are sellers, maybe farmers or village traders. There are intermediaries, licensed traders, commission agents or brokers, wholesalers, buyers, retailers, processors, exporters, facilitators like hamals, women, packers, and management of APMC and mandi officials. Now, second is electronic spot exchanges. It's a national level institutionalized and transparent electronic exchange. This exchange is expected to have solved the various problems faced by all the players in physical markets. It would provide real-time price information to the farmers and thus enable them to take informed decisions. And there are NCDEX spot exchange, NSEL, Reliance spot exchange. Now come to forward contracts. It's a bilateral agreement in which a buyer and seller agrees upon the delivery of a specified quality and specified quantity of an asset on a specified future date at predetermined prices. On the parties, one of the parties assume a long position and agrees to buy the underlying asset on a certain specified future date for a specific price, and other party assumes a short position, that is it agrees to sell the asset on a same date as the same specified price. For example, if a buyer A agrees to forward price of his soybean at rupees 3500 per quintal and seller A agrees to sell it at same price, they are agreeing on, suppose today they are agreeing on at this price to delivery on 15th of December. On 15th of December, the buyer will give the amount of 1300 per quintal on basis, and the seller will sell, give the physical delivery of the commodity. Then salient features of the forward contracts, these contracts are bilateral contracts and hence are exposed to counterparty risk. There is no third party involved in it. The contracts are privately negotiated, prices are not transparent, there is no regulation of these markets, there is no standardization lead to the absence of secondary markets, profits and losses are realized in terms of that. Now comes the futures trading. It is evolved out of forward contracts. It is an exchange traded version of the contracts. It contains standard specifications of the underlying asset in terms of quality and quantity of the produce, place of the delivery, date and time of the expiry of the contract. So to compare these, the spot and forwards are traded over the counter, while futures are traded on the exchange platform. Prices are determined in spot and forward through negotiation and determined privately, while prices in futures are determined private market dependent. The participants in futures are hedgers, speculators, arbitrageurs. Hedgers are those who want to transfer the risk, speculators are those parties who want to take the risk, and arbitrageurs are the market makers. So now we will try to understand what is the benefits of futures trading. Through futures trading, there is a proper price discovery and price dissemination takes place, price risk management can be taken place, then price stability, common platform for all traders it provides. There is low transaction cost through futures trading, there is absence of counterparty credit risk in futures, lower credit risk. Now, what is the price discovery in sense we would try to understand? It's a process of arriving a figure at which a person buys and another sells at a future contract for a specific expiration date, and that process starts from opening of the market to ends till closing of the market. So futures, though it's not a new thing in our country, it had started way back in 1875 when Bombay Cotton Trade Association has established cotton many exchanges came up, but particularly after independence in 1952, government came up with the Forward Contracts Regulation Act, and there are different committees set up to improve that upon. Commodities, as I said, is traded on exchange platform. There are different exchanges traded on, and there are national level multi commodity exchanges are NCDX, MCX, NMCE, UCX, ACE exchange and ICEX, and there are regional or specialized commodity exchanges. These markets are being regulated through Forward Markets Commission. Forward Markets Commission regulates both national as well as regional exchanges. We know now this national exchanges operate on online mechanism, while regional exchanges are specialized for different specific commodity, and their reach is to a specific region, while national commodity exchanges are large in expanding volumes. Agriculture, there are different commodities, agriculture commodities being traded like cereals and barley, wheat, maize, rice, pulses, spices, plantation, fiber, oils and oil seeds, then bullions like gold and silver, metals like aluminium, milk, lead, steel, then energy produce and weather are being traded on commodities platform. So the farmers can benefit through management of their price risk. Then they can have price discovery in market planning, then price information, they can again market plan and help in bargaining, then it improves marketing efficiency of farmers as well as other traders and reduce price volatility. So through this course, we had tried to learn what is commodity markets, how it works. But then what are different physical markets, forward transactions, futures transactions, and how those are beneficial to the all stakeholders in the market. For more information, what you need to do is you need to log on to manage website or the course material given to you from manage.